Alright, so this is another video tutorial, and in this tutorial we're going to see how we can make this logo in 3D. So this logo, as you can see, this is a brand from another popular agency of car, and we will try to handle this logo. So firstly, I have make the reference for our logo, and you can use any image reference, and I have used an BNG, which is maybe better for our case. And let's get started by making a circle, and after that we will try to decide which circle and how many vertices. So I will say that we have around 42, and in our case we will try to match the number of vertex here, and I will test this number for a moment. And we have the circle, and to be honest, we have only the reference collection, but I want to add a new collection, and this collection will be named to be the design, and I will move the circle, which may be here in some case. We will select the circle, and I will select it and move it to the design. And after that, as you can see, we have some reference here, and the circle matches the reference correctly, and I will move it to be here. Think that we have the number of vertex may match, so I will keep this number of vertex, but so I will select two vertex here and fill two in the side and two in the top and two in the bottom. And it's much better to activate the screencast case. Alright, so let's go back, and I will try to make this edge in the bottom matches correctly our reference, but I want to make something different, so I will try to activate. Alright, so I will move it in the upper part like this, and then I will extrude some time here. Basically, I haven't tried modeling this logo before, but I have made some similar logos for cars already. So let's get started, and we will make something. We will forget on this circle for a moment and try to add another thing. We will try from a plane, and I will move this plane, and again basically we have in the old version you can maximize this screen, but I don't know until this moment what is the shortcut for maximize the screen. So we will make some repetitive tasks. We will outline or we'll try to match all the lines, I mean the characters for this logo, which is the word of the Nissan. So I will try to select all these, and I will match properly for the word. And this is the repetitive task for this tutorial, so you can skip this part to the next part. And I think it must be better to activate the reference and to go to the MBT, and I want to make the opacity for this reference. We have the MBT, and we must have the opacity option, which is here. So I think that tracing the outlines or tracing the word isn't the hard thing. But I will also make the video visible, and I will try to make all the tutorial become in live mode. So I will try to duplicate some lines here, and these lines must be traced for the characters which we are going to match. Then I will extrude here, and after that I will duplicate in the x-axis, and I will add another loop cut here. And after that we have some lines here. And again we have another edge here. As you can see, the tracing isn't that hard, but I will try to explain something. So after matching the lines properly, as you can see here, we must make it straight. And sometimes move and slide this vertex. We have the in and we have the duplicate for the in, so I will duplicate in the x-axis to be here, and this is the first step. So the first step for making any 3D world, you should trace the items first, and then you must fill the gap in your design. And after that I will make some loop cut here and another two loop cuts here, and we have. So I will duplicate the X and mirror in the X axis. Right, so basically now we can say that we have the basic word or the basic design. And after that we will connect the edges. Let's move all this to be the down. Alright. Alright, so we have the word here. I will connect the edges between these lines. So we will start from the small part. We have here some small edges, or a number of vertex is lower than the right number, the right area which is here. So we will start from the lower number. I will select this vertex, and after that we have some edges here, and select this and fill the gap, and select here another loop cut here, and select and fill the gap. Alright, and we can connect this vertex. Make sure that you have used the polygon, and I want to make some round area to be here, which may be similar to an curve. And make sure that you have some symmetrical area. Alright, we will make something. We can move all these to the x-axis, and we can make three edges here, maybe two, and bevel, and another one here. And I want to select all these three and go to the edge mode and right click and bridge edge loop. So we have connected these. And I want to make another loop cut here. So this step may be not the one which you can feel enjoy for that, but this is the most important part, because up to this one we will connect all these plates to the outer a circle which we will define later. And after that, I will make some loop cut here. And after that, I will bridge edge loop, which is here. And again, I will select two loop cut here and fill these spaces. And we can also make another gap here and fill. And another. So if you start from the lower number of vertex, you can make it much easier for you. So as you can see, it's only some method, and we can say we are now done for this part. The same thing here, we can start from and we will try to make this a curve S, and after that we can go for now, and I will connect this. The same thing, I will make an bevel and select all these three vertex and go to the edge mode and bridge edge loop. And after that, we will connect these ones for here and these ones for here. So I will make an edge here and fill all these faces, and another edge, and make this edge inside the middle. And after that, I will make a loop and select all the three vertex and connect to this one. But also, as I have mentioned before, I will make this to be like a circle and scale in the axis like this, and connect to this one and make sure you are in the edge mode. And again, the same. Let's go back. I will make a loop here and fill all these. Alright, I think now we are done for this part, so we will try to connect the other parts. We can add loop cut here and going to fill all these faces, and I will connect this direct as I have mentioned. We can go, as you can see, we have make this many times before. And we have this three going to this three in the edge mode, and make sure we have bridge edge loop. Right. So basically, we will not animate this word, but all the way in all times, I will try to make all the faces to be polygons and try to neglect selecting angles any time. Because choosing the polygon much easier if you have added the subdivision surface. After that, you can see that the choosing the right face in the first method will become much easier for you. I think now we are close for finishing the tracing, and let's go back. Bridge edge loops as usual, and I will fill this one and fill this face. Alright. The remaining character is which is in, and I will fill some faces here and fill another one here. We have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 edges, so we want extra 3 edge here. So I will add 3 edges here and some edge here, which is going to inside this one. And then I will fill all these faces. And now we are done. So we have completed finally our plate, and this plate will be the main bottom and the main boundary for our logo. So I will select all the edges here and extrude one time for the z-axis, and let's extrude one time for the z-axis, and I will scale in the z-axis, and also I will extrude this one and scale in the z-axis to be 0. And basically we have to extrude some time, another time in the x-axis and another time in this axis. And after that, I will try to match or connect this one for the circle. So let's unhide the circle for a moment. And I will move this blade to the design, and we will say that this is to the outer area, and this one will be the words. Before moving to the next part, I will select this words and Shift D. I will duplicate and move to another collection. This collection will be maybe the trash can for a moment. And after that, I will hide the trash can. Alright. So we will now try to connect the circle. I think that we don't need the MBT for a moment. So we will try to connect this one to this one. So I will select all these, and let's delete, and we can start from the beginning, because we want to match them. So we have here around, I think we have 270. So I will select these two vertex and subdivide around 25. And let's join the outer area to the words, and we will join them here. So we have now this, it should be 27, and we have here 27. And now I will try to go to the edge and bridge edge loop. This is very handy way for bridging all these. So the same thing, we will try to match in the bottom area. We have 20, we have this time we have 30. So I will select this vertex and bridge. We will go for the right click and go to subdivide, and I will subdivide this time 28 time. So we have here 28 vertex, and we have here 30 and 30. We have the total number of vertex, which is the 60 vertex. And I will go a second time to the edge and bridge these edges. Right, and we want to try to fill this gap in the right area. So we have, let's count all the number here. We have the count number of 12. So, and we have here, we want another 10 vertex. So I will subdivide here 5 times and go to add 3 loop cuts here and 2 loop cuts here. So the total number of vertex will be 12, and we have here 12. So it's very useful to go again and bridge this edge loop and try to fill this final face which is here, founded here. And later we will try to trace the object which is here. Again, we have here, let's count the number of vertex. We have here 11, and in the we want another 9, so I will go for 5 here and 2 here and 2 here, and then I will go to select all these and try to bridge this edge loop. So we will go to bridge this edge loop. Alright, and again, as you can see, we in the right area we have to trace all these items. So I will go to move all these in the place which is here, and as you can see, in this time all these inside the shape is in flat mode, and later we will try to extrude this area. And I want to it here to this edge to be curved, so we will try to match them properly, and again try to match it here. As you can see, making a 3D logo, it can be hard if you have some complex shape, but for our shape we have only some 2D shape, and the process here is very simple. And let's go back. Let's trace this item. We want it to be here, and we want it to be here, and we want it to be here. Alright. And I will try to, and I think we are now around 20 minutes. So let's go straight to finish our we'll try to finish our logo before half an hour. So let's go back to trace all these items. I will go fast for the next minutes. Alright, now we are done for the outer shape. So I will go to extrude all these items, and make sure that you have selected all these areas. And I will make the cursor here by using right click and shift. You can using the make the cursor here, and make sure you have make the cursor to be the bounding box, and extrude scale and sometime here. Then I will go into the axis. And scale in the z-axis like this. Alright. After we have scaled, I will go to trace these items. Alright, I think now we have some duplicates, so I will select all and Alt-M merge by distance to remove all these 40-40 duplicates. So we can now move all these in the right places. I want to match the lines properly. then we can go straight and match these lines to in this edge, because we have already some edge here. So it doesn't matter the inner topology, but I want to match the edge properly. So I will select all these and move in the Z axis like this, and move here and move it to be here. Then I will select all this. I want it to be straight, so I will try to scale in the X Z axis. Let's wait for a moment, and I will scale in the Z axis like this, and after that I think that the outer shape isn't perfectly circle, so we can trace to the logo. And after that, because it's not symmetrical, so we should make the same thing here. So I will extrude scale some time, make sure that the cursor here, and I will extrude scale one time here until this, and then I will make the cursor here and try to go here and scale in the Z axis like this. May work, may not, it should work. But let's go back to the bounding box and scale in the Z axis and right. So I will trace this edge. Alright, and again we try to trace this one. Alright, so now it's the time to extrude in the Y axis, so we will extrude in the Y axis. And try So I will select all the characters to make some inset. So let's go to select all these characters. Simply you can choose selection of the circle and select all this one. And again, let's go back and select this one. It's now 30 minutes and we haven't finished yet the design. So let's go back. And we have this already. So we will try to extrude one time to the y-axis like this. And I will make hard edges here. And and finally, I think we are now done. But before we finish, we want to make this edge to be much better. So I will make an edge here, and I think this edge is straight. So I will select all the vertex, which is here. I will select all the vertex. And after that, scale in the z-axis, and make sure we have selected this one to be zero. And I will try to add loop cut here, and this loop cut will scale in the z-axis like this. And move in the y-axis sometime. So we will scale in all axes, not the y, and move in this area. So what if we add some subdivision surface? As you can see, we are here with the subdivision surface. We can see that in the original logo, we have some edges here, and we have this to be bumped. So I will select all these in this mode. I will select all this part. And going to activate the proportion editing and go to the smooth and move in the y-axis like this. Alright, and I think now we are finished for this tutorial. and make sure you have make it to be smooth. And if you have faced this problem, you can go to the face orientation, and as you can see, there is a lot of normals that they must be fixed by shift in like this and all to be one color. And we are now done for this one. So I will leave the source files in the description for this video, and see you in the next lesson.